Hello everyone, I hope you guys are doing absolutely fine. Let us study of Abrus Precatorius. We have already covered rest of the vegetable poisons in our previous lecture. Go check out the playlist. So, Abrus Precatorius is commonly known as Ratti or Gunji. These are the seeds of Abrus Precatorius, which are extremely poisonous portion of this entire plant. This is how the leaves of these plants look like. To begin with, let us have a look at some of its common name which can be asked in your competitive examinations. It is commonly termed as crab's eye. Why? Because of the nature and the appearance of the seeds of the plant. Then rosary pea. This is known as a rosary. It is often used for purpose of worship and has a great religious significance and importance as well. Paternoster pea. Then love pea, P word is missing here, precatory pea or bean, then prayer bead. As I have already told you, rosary is used for purpose of praying, so it is also known as rosary pea or prayer bead. These are the beads of Abrus Precatorius. Then if we talk about distribution of this plant, so it is found all over the nation and it belongs to leguminaceae family. Moreover, you must know that entire plant is poisonous. In Brazil, this plant is proclaimed as an invasive weed. Weed means plants which are completely of no use but are of extremely harm, as they compete with the growth and nutrition of the other plants which can be of great use. So these weeds mostly spread in large amount and they are mostly uncontrollable. Like, you know, the case of terror of Bengal, that is water hyacinth. It was a massive disaster that took place in Bengal. Okay, so somewhat like this, it is proclaimed that Abrus was also once a weed in some region of Belize, then Caribbean island, Hawaii, Polynesia and other parts of United States. Okay, now how to identify the seeds of Abrus plant? These are the seeds of Abrus Precatorius, as I have already shown you in the very first introductory slides. These seeds are egg shaped, means somewhat oval, and are scarlet in color. This is not red color, or there are variations of red color. Even I am not familiar with all these variations, so for me it's simply red color, but no, they call it scarlet. So okay, we have to go with the bookish language sometimes. It is scarlet and has this black spot in the end, at the one end. Even white seeds are also found in some cases. Now if we talk about dimension of the seed, is somewhere varies between 0.83 into 0.62 centimeter. Its weight is 105 milligram, whereas the seeds are odorless, means they have no smell of its own and is tasteless as well. Okay, it is used by goldsmith. Who are goldsmith? People who are concerned with the manufacturing of different ornaments from gold, silvers. In Hindi we commonly called it sunar, like that of the ironsmith who are concerned, who are working with irons to prepare different equipments from iron. So these were the professionals with their work, and they use it for weighing silver and gold products. Now if we talk about the active principles, seeds of Abrus Precatorius commonly contain abrine, abrine and abrilene. It is thermostable toxalbumin. What if a compound is thermostable? Means it can automatically adjust itself in any environment. It will get back to the normal temperature. It is thermally stable, means no harm can be caused to it in high or low temperature. Then abrine. It is a kind of amino acid and also shows the property of hemoagglutination, means agglutination of blood. Then an abrilene is a glycoside. A glycoside simply means any of the naturally occurring substances in which a carbohydrate portion would contain one or more sugar. Fine, so this was the explanation of each and every glycosides of Abrus Precatorius. Let us have a look at some of its common symptoms. It will cause abdominal pain if ingested, nausea or vomiting as well. Then There will be some symptoms of bloody diarrhea, weaknesses followed by weakness of pulsation as well as rectal bleeding, as it is severely harmful to the gastrointestinal tract. These are the reasons, these are the common symptoms that are very clearly evident to it, isn't it? Then tachycardia, increase in the heart rate, headache along with dilation of pupils and hallucinations as well. You know what are the hallucinations? People start getting some of the false sensations, like if a person is hallucinating, means they will be able to hear some of the sounds which actually do not exist. They might hear that someone is calling them, and in reality nobody would do that, isn't it? They would get some auditory or some gustatory hallucinations as well, olfactory hallucinations. Person would experience some kind of taste, something is there in their mouth, but in actual nothing would be there inside their mouth. Okay, and when extract of seed is injected under the skin, even the extract of seed is used as a source of poison. So some symptoms would this is the most important thing. Question of often asked, that which organic poison resembles the viperine snake bite, or which resembles the nature of poison similar like that of the viper snake. So it is obviously Abrus Precatorius. The symptoms are extremely similar like that of the viper snakes, like viper snake bite. Okay, so some of the common symptoms which are similar in case of viper snake bite and Abrus Precatorius can be inflammation, edema, oozing of hemorrhagic fluid from the side from where the poison is being injected. Okay, and this edema and inflammation will be present at the site from where the poison is injected. You must keep this in mind. Then at size of injection, there will be swelling, which will obviously be painful, along with eczema developed. Fine. Now the fatal dose include 90 to 120 milligram of abrine injected, or 1 to 2 crushed seeds which will orally administered in the body of the person or the sufferer, which is approx 0.1 to 1 gram per kg body weight of the person. Then fatal period often varies from 3 to 5 days. Now the treatment. Inject anti-abrine and needle if present, in case of like we studied that some of the extract are provided or given to the person from needle in the form of liquid mostly. So this needle need to be dissected out from the body to lower the effect. Then hydrochloric pepsin is naturally administered in the body of the person. Then urine is maintained at alkaline pH. Fine. Now some of the common post-mortem finding, if person has taken or it is forcefully given to the person in the form of injection, then needle must be present. Edema would be observed at the site of needle, of the site of injection, as we learnt about it. Then petechial hemorrhage can be seen under the skin of the person, and gastrointestinal tract may observe edema, congestion, or some of the hemorrhages. Then internal organ could also be congested in such cases, along with hemorrhage and edema of lymph node.